Donald Trump has now cemented his status as the Republican presidential standard bearer in the fall. He clinched the delegates needed for the nomination today, even as he took fire from the man who holds the job now. John Yang begins our coverage.
The folks behind me got us right over the top from North Dakota. So
literally North Dakota, backed by his North Dakota delegates, Donald Trump celebrated his status as the now certain nominee at a news conference in Bismarck. The Associated Press reports that one of those delegates gave him the 1,237th vote he needs to win on the first ballot at the Republican convention. It came on the same day that President Obama used his own news conference at the G7 summit in Japan to say that world leaders are worried about a Trump presidency.
They're rattled by it, and for good reason, because a lot of the proposals that he's made display either ignorance of world affairs or a cavalier attitude or an interest in getting tweets and headlines.
Trump dismissed the president's criticism.
Many of the countries in our world, a beautiful world, have been absolutely abusing us and taking advantage of us. So if they're rattled in a friendly way, we're going to have great relationships with these countries. But if they're rattled in a friendly way, that's a good thing, John, not a bad thing.
Even as he clinched the nomination, Trump faces more turmoil within his campaign staff. His national political director, Rick Wiley, is out just 6 weeks after he was brought on to help professionalize the Trump effort. In a statement last night, the campaign insisted that Wiley was always a short-term hire. Trump seemed delighted by the fact that his nomination, once thought improbable, was decided before the Democrats.
And here I am watching Hillary fight, and she can't close the deal.
In fact, Hillary Clinton is within 78 delegates of locking up her party's nomination. But a new poll shows her in a virtual tie with Bernie Sanders in the California primary less than 2 weeks away. Today, Clinton reacted to Trump going over the top.
That means an unqualified loose cannon is within reach of the most powerful job in the world.
Clinton also dismissed a State Department watchdog report that found she violated policy by using a private email server as Secretary of State. She told a Univision affiliate last night, "I will continue to be open, and it's not an issue that's going to affect either the campaign or my presidency."
Here's the question from Bernie.
Sanders, meanwhile, used late-night talk show host Jimmy Kimmel to challenge Trump to a debate. Trump says he'd do it for a price.
Oh, I'd love to debate Bernie. He's a dream. Well, I said, and I said last night on Jimmy's show, a question that was posed, and I said I'd love to debate him, but I want a lot of money to be put up for charity. So what we'll do is if we can raise for maybe women's health issues or something.
You raise $10 million, you'll get on a debate stage with Bernie Sanders.
I would love to, yeah.
Today, Sanders said he can't wait.
And I'm very excited about it. And I think we're going to have to rent out the largest stadium you have here in California.
Sanders had asked Clinton to debate, but she declined. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang.
We'll focus on how foreign leaders are reacting to the rise of Donald Trump after the news summary.